and I listened to his voice. He was an extraordinary singer. He still is. But now he lives in Australia. No accounting for that. But I jokingly said to him, please write me some songs and I'll do a solo album because it might get you a record deal. And 10 days later, he turned up with 10 songs, him and his partner, Dave Courtney. His name was Leo Sayer. And he wrote me some songs for a first album, solo album. I had no intention of being a solo singer at all. Absolutely none whatsoever. But unfortunately, to get one record out, you have to sign a deal for three, which gave me huge headaches and sleepless nights because I was in love with making the first one. It was done for a reason. The songs were written for me. But to find the rest of the songs I wanted to do became ever more difficult. And I kind of haven't got a solo career now. But this one was a big success. I love this song.
Portsmouth.
All right. Okay, our violinist. Katie Jacoby. Now, Katie, she comes from New York. She lives in New York. And Katie is the leader of the orchestra when the Who tour. And we go out with an orchestra these days. It's, believe me, it is not wishy-washy. It's not an orchestra playing pads. It's an orchestra playing serious orchestrations. You know? It's massive. It's absolutely massive. Now, Katie is the lead violinist. She's our librarian who gets the music organised every day for every show. She's a serious classical musician. And during the lockdowns in New York, she received virtually nothing from the government over there, so she was really struggling. And it's great to have her on this tour. Katie, you are fabulous. You are really, truly fabulous. So we found her in New York, and I was introduced to Katie from the conductor of our orchestra, who's an old friend, a guy called Keith Levinson. And God, it's been a great relationship. We've had so much fun. She is so solid. So, what a musician. Anyway, Kevin from LA, well, what is the most memorable show that you could have played in California? Well, that's bloody easy. There's only one that could, you know, could take the kind of credit for that. We were doing the Cow Palace in 1973. It was the first tour of Quadrophenia in America. It was the first show in America. And the Cow Palace is a place in San Francisco which was built for cows. It really was. They didn't call it the Cow Palace for nothing. It was built to herd, you know, where they herded the animals in to go to market before they went for slaughter. They herded us in there before we went to slaughter that night. But that was a night that Keith Moon, who would take anything that anybody gave him, they said, "This is going to make you happy, Keith." Ooh, right. So I gave him some kind of tranquilizer, which we don't know whether it was a horse tranquilizer or a monkey tranquilizer. There's been lots of rumors about what kind of tranquilizer it was, but it must have been something special, because halfway through the show, Keith Moon kind of faded, and then finally passed out. He was slapped about a bit by our manager and put back on the stool, and he played another song and then completely collapsed. And it took him 3 days to come round. Now that's some drug, I tell you. So that's the most memorable. Nothing can ever beat that. To be there that night. First of all, it was extremely worrying because we thought he'd died. Secondly, you know, it took him 3 days to come round, so we had to move a lot of shows to accommodate the schedule. That was a nightmare. And to this day, we've never found out who gave him it. Apparently they were a doctor. I don't think they were a doctor at all. But Keith will believe anybody. He was a treasure. Anyway, we're going on, and this one is actually from Quadrophenia, where it wasn't the original record, but it's heavily featured in Quadrophenia. Number called The Kids Are Alright. I don't mind all the guys in the body.
You will be high with the future. know if I go on, be alive there for her. I think it's playing beautiful to let her. Sometimes I feel I gotta get away.
Song that's again way ahead of its time. We recorded this song in 1966 for the album Who Sell Out. And typical Pete Townsend, he seemed to write songs that life kind of caught up with. Kind of weird. It's a song called Tattoo. And of course, way back then, very uncool to have a tattoo unless you were a sailor, or you've been in the army, or been in the Nick. So nowadays, people are covered in them. The beach is going to look like a load of washed up old newspaper in 20 years' time. Anyway, it's a wonderful, wonderful song, and it just indicates the humour that Pete has in him. I love this song. It's a great song to sing. Joined by my friend, my brother, Simon Templeton. To each other about what makes a man. Is it brain or brawn or a few of all? We just couldn't understand. Our old man didn't like our appearance. He said that only women wear long hair. So me and my brother borrowed money from mother. We knew what we had to do. We went downstairs past the barber and gymnasium and got our arms tattooed. Welcome to my night tattoo. We've a long time together, me and you. I expect I'll regret you, but the skin rot there won't get you. You'll be there when I die. Tattoo. Well, my dad beat me, 'cause mine said mother, but my mother actually liked it. Beat my brother, 'cause his tattoo was on a lady in the nude, and she thought that was extremely rude. Welcome to my life tattoo. I'm a man now, face to you. I expect I'll